less, but qualitatively they create more impact. For example, the size of an atom bomb is no doubt lesser than the size of a building, but when it explodes, colossal loss is experienced. Like that, there is a connective attribution. If somebody, what you are told is correct, if somebody is in an airport, just I went there, the security person told that Baba actually, without that, that is his personal wish. Then he told that it is your personal wish. If in anywhere in India, a person dressed like me, if you bring something, I will be the first person to be checked. If any person in my own dress, if you bring something, if he smuggles or if he traffics something, or if he holds weapons or does something in my disguise, then I will be targeted in each and every airport. So, it is a mass impression. It is a pseudo impression that if you continuously, it is known as repetitive imaging. If media or public or the general agencies, if they repetitively say about this fellow has done that, this fellow has done that, it's continuously the name of the person, the religion to which he belongs, the reason that he states, if everything is repetitively projected in the society, that creates a mass indelible impression in the society. It is a psychological error. And as connective attribution, as somebody has told that, as yeah, there is a conspicuous connectivity. For example, there is a person known as Sardar. And Sardar is easily identifiable by his appearance and other thing, by his name and other thing. If it is not so conspicuous, they cannot do that. If it is so conspicuous by the name, by the appearance, by some other clan which is very much impressive, then immediately this rule of connective attribution there. So psychologically, this is known as number one, misinterpretation and malpractice of religious principles, which has resulted in shielding and sheltering into unlawful endorsements. These unlawful proposals have resulted in mass impression by repetitive demonstration or projection, which has resulted in connective attribution of suspicion. This should be ruled out only by those people. See how to do that? There are two things for religious harmony, I used to say. One, to disown your own people if they are against you, against your religious principle. To own or embrace people who are against the universal truth or universal precision. If somebody is not belonging to my own tradition, if they are common in universalizing a tradition or principle which is accepted by all, even though he is different from me, he is my person. Even if it is my own son, if he is against the religious principle, the doctrine of peace, the harmony and the collective survival in the society, I should disown by these people. So there should be an elite, a compatibly competent members of the other one Islam society, they should come forward to repetitively, they have to create the counter image for that. As media is a mass industry, they can easily create image. To create counter image, it will take decades of years, hundreds of people should collectively work out for that. To create a false image is very easy. To make a scar, that's what I used to say. For fire to burn your finger, it will take 2 seconds. For the burner to work on your finger, it will take 10 days. Like that, counter imaging is very difficult. There are a few reasons for terrorism. Number one, it is against one rule or army. Number two, it is for separating a country. Or it is against any religious principle. Fourth, it is against economic deprivation of a particular community. Fifth, to reduce the domination of a counter-ethnic class. These 5 things are, as per the research, they have told that these are all the reasons. So these reasons are never-ending. If somebody has taken the oath that unless these persons are totally annihilated, I will not disown myself, it is very difficult. Britain can do only the least. Only the social intelligence, collective intelligence of the society, we should be alive, our relatives should be alive, and our children should live in a peace and secure society. It should be our role, and we have to create a model for that. Government will come only for emergency service and extraordinary service or occasional services. Daily we have to take care of ourselves. It is our sworn in duty with our internal security mechanism.
We have a innovative approach. I am Karan Varma. I have been writing on racial security for about 30 years. His insurgency, his terrorism. Now I am liking how the community should be prepared for man-made and natural disasters. Swamiji, I want to make a small request that people like you have to create an index in the mind of these states and the community. This index is non-existence. My effort in the last 10 years has been how to create index or man-made and natural disasters at the school level, at the family level, at the national level. Don't worry about government. Don't worry about other people. Let's have a people's partnership power. People's partnership power to move the things upward. That's a bottom-up approach. Bottom, we have talked about bottom-up approach. Government will do, then I will be secure for terrorism. I don't know what to let's do something. Now, gentlemen, you are here. I'm making a small announcement. I am working on Safer School, Safer Mumbai. Anybody here to join? Safer Mumbai, Safer Schools. I am working. I am launching the campaign. I have an organization which has trained 1,65,000 people in 10 states of India. No one comes to Karan Varma and that organization in the last 10 years. They come to phase 3. When something happens in Mumbai, then they come to phase 3, photographs, and they're experts. They say they're experts on racial security, and that expert is forgotten after 2 days. My humble request here, IMC, and my friends, I'll give the contact. Swamiji, I want a commitment from you. Mind mapping of self-index for corruption and terrorism and man-made and natural disasters. One small street child, I was hanging a workshop for them, how to protect from man-made and natural disasters. I asked the child, Beta, why terrorism? I'm an expert on terrorism, right on terrorism. What definition the child gave to me, the street child gave to me? Sir, the children who do not get love and affection of the society and the nation become terrorists. He defines everything in it to what? So, sir, I'll have your blessings. No query, no questions to you. It's an excellent explanation, but the explanation has gone down to the lowest man. Thank you so much. I'm grateful.
Actually, religious power has two phases. One is humanism, second is dynamism. To love everybody, to be soft with everybody, to forgive their mistakes, everything forms the phase of humanism. But only those who deserve that humanistic approach, they should be given that. The other phase is dynamism, to curb out terrorism, to trample on the necks of the evil forces. Religion should also provide the courage to do that, either directly or collectively or through imperial or organized or authenticated agencies. We should do that. But most of the religious people, they develop only soft-mindedness, like crying before serials or divine ecstasy. Only that idea of humanism or soft-mindedness is given in religion. Religion has such a powerful power to make you dynamic. If they are human, make the humanistic behavior. If they are totally non-human, inhuman or anti-human, you show your dynamic face. Any person who is trained in a real religious potency will be capable of doing all the things, he can face all the people. Such a training should be implanted in schools, in houses, as well as in religious institutions.